For over 700 years, the Cambodian people have lived in the midst of war and violence. During these dark ages, neighboring countries invaded and conquered the land. Control of Cambodia changed hands numerous times between Thailand and Vietnam. And finally, the Khmer Rouge. In 1975, under this new communist regime, educated professionals were purged, churches and temples destroyed, and thousands of urban dwellers driven into the countryside for primitive agricultural labor. The outcome was a regime of horrific brutality, which was responsible for yet another 20th century genocide. It is estimated that one-third of the population was killed in 4 years, leaving many children orphaned. Now, what remains is a population dominated by young people. 49.5% of Cambodia's population is under the age of 18. With the lack of educated predecessors, it will not be long before these youth step into positions of leadership and power. They are the hope for a new chapter. They are the future of Cambodia. And that's why these youth became our mission. Our team hosted a youth conference for one specific purpose: to fuel the lives of Cambodian teenagers with the love of Christ. As we kicked off the conference, we started to experience the challenges of ministering cross-culturally. Simple English and body language were insufficient for communication. Furthermore, the Cambodian youth were extremely shy and unaccustomed to our strange American games. But it wasn't long before they opened up and were soaring in high spirits. Especially in light of their history, it meant so much to see the room full of smiles and laughter. Just as you are to worship. Come. Just as you are before your God. Come. One day every tongue will. As we continued to play, eat, and live together, we soon forgot our differences and developed a bond beyond words. But our most precious times with the youth were unarguably the worship services. As our team proclaimed scriptural truths through dance, drama, and messages, we were pleasantly surprised by the passion for worship and prayer. However, it also became clear that there were misconceptions about what it meant to be a true disciple of Christ. Teachings on the cost of discipleship and sacrificial Christianity seemed to be a foreign concept. However, as a bar was raised during the conference, the Holy Spirit moved, and the Cambodian youth responded with an equally high level of commitment. We began our project unsure of how we would minister to people who are from a different culture and speak a different language. But now, God has shown us that the love of Christ is a language that anyone can understand. How beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Isaiah 52:7.